Hello everybody, my name's Dapriva and welcome back to some more Europa Universalis 4 playing as Prussia. Yeah, the end of last episode we decided to finally form Prussia from Brandenburg. And I guess we're pretty powerful as it is, and we're only gonna get more powerful over time. Now we just need to make happy with Oldenburg so we can actually get them into a vassal as well. We have a lot of negatives going on with them right now. We're getting minus 6 yearly and plus almost 5, but the improved relations can always be countered. So it's a couple more years probably, and then we can ask them as well. We've gained the reconquest against Lithuania and the Livonian Order because we just formed Prussia. And Lithuania basically has Zimachia, that's considered our core, and Courland is also considered our core. I can give up my core over here, but it does cost me 10 prestige, but the Livonian Order is my vassal anyway, so I don't have to do that. Riga, we could get them to 100 minus 21 is 80 something, plus, and they're monastic, so we couldn't marry them anyway, so not a real reason. The allies of, yeah, Lithuania has France as an ally. So if we were to declare war on them, France would join in. And that's not something I want to see happen at all. Novgorod does not like us either at minus 30, minus 27 now. Neighboring heretic religion. Are we neighboring even? Not really. Finland also doesn't like us. Sweden hates our guts, but mostly because they want all of our stuff. And they've just announced us as a new rival. Yeah, we still have rivals Muscovy, Poland, and Lithuania. And we've converted Rupin, which does not leave much left to convert. Ratibor is about to be flipped automatically, so I'm not gonna even bother sending in our own missionary. I mean, 93%, it's almost done. Ah, and Lübeck is now getting an auto-conversion as well. We are, of course, already coring it, but that means we don't have to send in a missionary either. That means that the entirety of Brandenburg, now Prussia, will soon be Protestant. There's Potsdam done, so we now have two missionaries available. I also have 4 diplomats that I'm not doing anything with right now. I can fabricate a claim on Bremen, though, so I should definitely do that. Oldenburg is 126. It dropped again. They do desire provinces. Yeah, there are a lot of negatives going on here, which is very annoying. Claim, casus belli. Probably their claim on us, I would assume. They have a... Well, we have a claim on Osnabrück, but we are converting it. What are they claiming? Oh, of course, up here, East Frisia, or Ostfriesland, right now, German, renamed. Muscovy has announced us as their rival as well. There we go, that was Ratibor being converted automatically, which probably means that their unrest has dropped significantly. So we currently have to deal with just a few more unrests. Why is Ermland so unruly? Oh, it's mostly our overextension, but that's soon gone anyway. Trier is, oh, completely back to Catholic now. It's a shame. Oh, Galra is not actually Protestant, though. Yeah, the annexed vassal. That takes about 100 years to go away with Galra right now, which is a pain in the ass. So, Bremen is also gonna take that long. It's gonna be a while before we can actually integrate these two, then. I have to make sure that when we do, though, it's at a good point. Utrecht, would we be even... Yeah, they would accept it if we had the relations, which we by far do not. Lübeck and Osnabrück are now a part of the patrimony. Lübeck is getting an automatic conversion. How much is it? Minus 3.33. I think it's faster if I just start sending someone. Oh, Pomeranian is actually now not a accepted culture anymore, but it is still It's still in the German and the Prussian, Germanic culture group, so they still like us a little bit. There's that. How long? No, hang on. See, it says unrest for reducing our, for decreasing autonomy, but where's the modifier? Need tech level 22 to create client state. Yeah, that's something for in the future. Ah, here it is. Oh, 10 more years. I'm stuck with that. Anyway, I think we can easily do military tech 11 right now. Combat width increase, cavalry fire, infantry shock. And one more level and we get even better infantry again. As well as military tactics level up. Ooh, that is so good. We're still 13 years ahead of time. Oh, early reformers. When news of the Protestant faith spread to our land, we were among the first to accept it. We know where the future of the Christian faith lies, and while less enlightened nations may take their time to get there and need to be dragged along, we march proudly towards it. Fortunately, we are not surrounded by these fools on all sides. The rulers of a neighboring country have taken the same admirable path, freeing themselves from the clutches of the Pope and educating themselves in Protestant theology. The Church of Prussia may hold the foremost scholars, but there may yet to be much to learn from others. Sweden and opinions change. Oh, yeah, I like that idea. Let's actually improve our relations with Sweden. Maybe then they will decide to actually not want our provinces. Ah, they are our rival. We have each other. No, they have us as a rival. I'm still gonna improve relations. I mean, they're probably never gonna release that rivalry, so. They are willing to trust us at least, but. Yeah. They're allied only with Muscovy right now. That would join, and they do have Norway as a vassal. Oh boy, Scandinavia strong. That's a certainty. Let's see. Munster does hate us. Hesse does not actually hate us right now, but yeah, there's still a lot of negatives going on here. Saxony is less bad actually. Let's just improve both of these back up to max again then. Too high base tax. I think the same will be the deal with Saxony. And they're an elector actually. No way that's gonna be working out. Palatinate. I could vote for Bohemia to become the emperor. That would shake things up. But yeah, the Palatinate supports themselves because we are supporting them. But if we don't support them, then they would support Austria again and not Bohemia. Which is a shame. Palatinate, we are very good in relations, actually. Yeah, and they, of course, are also dealing with everything. We can invest in a new idea. I think that should be done. Yeah, we are far ahead of military again. So now our army morale speed recovery is higher again. Next up is cavalry combat ability. Can I build some more farm estates? Yes, I can, and I shall. Just to get my income increased. I'm getting so much money that it's worthwhile the long. I think the long-term investment is definitely worthwhile. Just one red. Ooh, the League of Schmalkalden. After Emperor Charles V had rejected the Protestants' confessional positions at the Imperial Parliament of Augsburg, the North German Protestant Imperial Estates formed the League of Schmalkalden, with a joint army and treasury and seeking ties abroad in France. The League enjoyed early successes in the years 1532-1540. The emperor was threatened by Turkish danger and forced to conclude religious peace settlements in Nuremberg and Caden. Opinion of Prussia changed to a couple of nations. Give it our we are going to give it our support. Let's recall that diplomat. Which did it include? It did not include Oldenburg. Oh, that's a shame. Did include relations with England going up, and actually, I don't mind getting improved relations with England for a change. Yeah, strange that they haven't decided to convert just yet. That might come though. Oldenburg needs to flip over in religion. That would actually make them want to join us completely. Independence guaranteed, military access allowed. We can't get another plus six. The conversion needs to happen that direction. Diplomatic insult on Bremen or try to ease tension with all of our neighbors. Including Oldenburg, actually. Well, that changes everything. Come home from Sweden if you want. That's actually the perfect event to get right now. Because now we can get to 190. It's just perfect, really. This way. And we're allied anyway, so it's not gonna lose us any kind of relationship at all. Okay, from Hesse is coming back now anyway. And we have religious unity. The entire nation has been converted. We are 100% Protestant right now. And that is very nice. Yes, let's call back from Hesse. And offer vassalization to Oldenburg. And they are now our vassal as well. Perfect. And then I can increase the vassalized Saxony. That is actually a very good one. Who are your allies? Cologne and Ulm. Then I'm going to pick up this mission as a vassal of us. Then again, we do have 7 out of 6 relationships. The Royal Marriage with Austria. I think we can cancel that. Yeah, we have, other than the Platinate, everyone else is also a vassal. Yeah, the only thing that would go against that would actually to... I'm going to pick up Vassalize Saxony. Yeah, I'm also going to cancel the Royal Marriage with Austria. So, I'm really sorry guys, but we're going to break royal ties with you. Does a drop in stability, but I can increase it for only 72. That's actually very tempting to go even further than that then, but... We'll leave it as is. It means we have that relationship free, finally. Oldenburg broke their alliance. Well, they're now my vassals, so it's not very useless that they did that. And Saxony, seriously, is it true? Good relations, minus one stability. Something I don't want. We'll greatly disturb our relations with them. But that is just so I don't have to lose this stability as either. I'm going to vassalize an elector. And they're allied to Ulm and Cologne. Yeah, well, we have our vassal swarm ready as well, so... Nothing to worry about, actually. Declare war, they will join, take capital Leipzig. Yeah, sure. And we have a working casus belli, so it's not that bad anyway. We do have full military. Yeah, I never dropped it again after attacking Lübeck. Oh, one problem though. Aggressive expansion is high as hell. Then again, they might not care about it actually. Hang on. I cannot send someone right now. Detach a siege, go to Thüringen. We are now also at war with... We can actually... Yes, good Aachen. Aachen is taking them on. So, if I were to get a vassalage going, most of the world will hate us. But I think I'm in a position where I can handle a coalition war with our amount of vassals. And then including Saxony as a vassal as well. That's a good one. They will join us. And that will actually encircle Magdeburg completely. How fast does it drop anyway? 3 every year with them. Well, it's not like they already hate us so badly right now. Broke royal marriage. We are increasing every year though. But if the war lasts at least until 1534, we should be decent when it comes to our aggressive expansion dropping after that. Can I even get into Ulm? No, I cannot. Let's go through Würzburg. Yeah, aggressive expansion is an issue, of course. Let's recall the diplomat. they're gonna join in anyway. But the thing is, if we have positive relations with people, then they will not join anything. So I'm gonna improve our relationship with Munster for now. So we actually don't get that many in a coalition against us. Biggest problem will still be Austria. Army size. Total army, Austria has an army about, Jesus Christ, so much bigger than ours. And France doesn't actually hate us. This is worth a, we kind of hate France, though. We hate France, sadly. They don't hate us, we hate them. And they're expanding into Italy now as well. Oh well. Palatinate is reformed there. Yeah. I wonder when we can, if and when we can actually change that through the new religious warfare mechanic thing. Holy crap! My army force limit is... Oh, hang on, we have something going on. The increased offensive, yeah, we have a plus 25% right now. So our army force limit is not very high, sadly. I can actually build an armory again. Yes, let's build a barracks in our capital at least. Let's see, where are our training fields very useful? Definitely in these three. For Pomeran as well. So also in due time, increase my force limits as well. Provincial unrest is almost negligible. I mean, there's not even any rebel factions active right now, so... Nothing to worry about. Ah, Cologne. If we were to do something with you, I can call him back at least from Oldenburg. So if I want to sue for peace with them... Berk to Munster. Yeah, Munster would like that, but... Cologne would definitely not. Evoke the core, no. Make them our vassal, it will piss off everyone as well. Not as bad as Saxony, but we'll still piss off people. She's gonna go with war reparations, and they would actually not accept that. Oh, the war hasn't even been that long, but they'll soon be kind of... Yeah, Siege of Leipzig, Siege of Saxon. I think I can pull some troops back already. Even that big of a deal. Oh, hello, Ulm. Are you finally deciding to join here? They did bring a leader and select the army. We're not attaching, so. Oh, okay. We just won the war, the siege of Thuringia, so not that bad. Let's see. Where the hell are they going? Yes. I'm trying to find them now. 26th, 25th, yes, let's join in here. Let's take the Ulmish army out as well. You cannot get to Ulm either, but that's fine. When the army is down, it means even more war score. Popular noble, plus one diplomatic reputation for a while. I don't have that much problems with our... right now, so I'm not even worried. So Saxony, they would still not accept vassalization because we need movement through Würzburg. Will they give it to us? They actually will. Okay, Würzburg giving us access means we can actually send our army. Early reformers, Saxony's opinion of Prussia changed by plus 60. Well, yeah, it's the second time this triggers, so maybe it will keep triggering if we... Yeah, and we do need some friendliness with them when we do... See, they're still positive despite being at war. which is hilarious. Let's go all to Ulm then. Yeah, one army is just ahead of the other. We're just going to Ansbach no further. Cologne has been sieged up completely. Should be enough to take the peace now. Yes, it is. Can declare peace. And I think... Ooh, Saxony will release Cleves. Where is Cleves anyway? Oh, that's seriously a part of Cologne? Hang on. Or is that a part of Würzburg? I'm not even sure right now. Württemberg, do you exist? Yeah, you do. So where would Cleves be? Here. Yeah, it would be Berg. Ah, that's fine then. Let's put that as a part of the peace deal as well. So we are now asking for Cleves be freed. Cannot ask war reparations. I think we're going to do this. Send the demand. It's January. Well, it actually is 1534. Perfectly fine. And they are now my vassal, which is perfect. Also, you guys, I need to cancel military access as soon as possible, once my troops are out. But I want to thank you all for watching. Make sure to like if you enjoyed and subscribe if you want to keep updated in the future. I will see you guys later.